Hey, this week we are going to create a series Bible for the Life After series, which I am republishing myself. If you're new here, my name is Katlyn Duncan, and I am a hybrid author, which means I have both traditional and self-published books. Here on my channel, we talk about the writing process and all the bookish things, so if that interests you at all, be sure to subscribe and ring the notification bell so you know the next time I upload. So this week we are going to be working on my series Bible, a little backstory on the books. This is a trilogy that was originally published in 2013 and 2014. It was reverted back to me in 2020, and now I'm republishing the books myself. And even though I have written several series, I've never created a series Bible, and I've always wanted to, and now that I'm moving forward with this series, the last book needs to be completely overhauled, so I want to make sure that all the details are perfect for this round of republishing. So today is Sunday, October 24th, and this is the second day that I've been working on the series Bible. The first day I took part in the worldwide write-a-thon. I was a host, so it was way too chaotic for me to be able to host and start the blog. So I'm gonna go over what I've done so far. So this is a proof copy of Soul Taken. This is the matte finish, and it has the not for resale stripe from Amazon. I did end up going with the glossy finish, which I talked about in this video, if you are interested in seeing my decision making for that. And it also has a bit of a formatting issue. Not really a bad issue, but I formatted the book myself in vellum, and I didn't really like the style that I chose once it was like in my hands and I could see it in book form. I wasn't doing anything with this copy. I didn't really want to throw it away. So I'm using it to do highlights and note characters and settings and lore and all of that with my series Bible. So what I did yesterday is I went through almost all of the book, I'd say about 75%, you can see here, and I noted in just a regular notebook any characters, settings, lore, and also I noted a few areas where I wanted to make sure I pulled threads through in book two, which was like a little added surprise for myself. So I have about 10 pages of notes. I'm gonna finish this up today in Julie's stream for the Worldwide Write-a-thon I am co-hosting. So let's get started. Okay, for the first 12 minutes or so of the sprint, I finished the book. So I got through the whole book. I made tons and tons of notes in here about characters and settings and everything. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna set up a sort of table of contents template in Word. I tend to do systems frequently, so if I ever do another series, I'd like to have this as an actual template. So I'm gonna create the template first, save it as a template, and then start implementing what I wrote down here into that document. So I'm gonna go off and do that now. So my sprints for the Worldwide Write-a-thon are over and I'm exhausted. I didn't realize how much work this would take and it's just overwhelming. But at the same time, it feels really good to output all of this information into one place so that I don't have to keep rereading my book if I need any more information about character traits or things like that. And this book has lived with me for a long time, but it's nice to re-familiarize myself with all of the nitty-gritty details for when I do my drafting next month. So I'm gonna take a break from that now. I went through about 3 pages in my notebook, and I think I output 5 or 6 pages, I don't remember, but I am going to continue to work on it this week, and you'll see that in a moment. Well, happy Halloween. It's Halloween night around 8:30. And I just finally got kiddo to bed and I'm about to start working on my series Bible, finishing my series Bible. I kind of got away from me this week. I had other things that I wanted to be doing, and I really need to get this done before my retreat because I want to be as fully prepared as possible when I go on it. So I'm gonna work on that now. Julie from Pages and Pens does a Sunday night sprint every week, and I'm gonna join that for a little bit, and hopefully I can get some, if not all of it, done. So here she is, the final series Bible for now. This is a work in progress for me. So this is a binder. I think I got it from the dollar store, and also these little tabs here from the dollar store. So this one is the table of contents. I already have a few things that I'd like to change. So when it comes to the table of contents, we'll go through everything. I do have like page numbers and stuff, but I really don't think I will do that in the future. And I also hole punch these before I realized how flimsy they were, so I put them in plastic protectors. So the first section, table of contents, then characters. So what I did is I created for the main character, Maggie, she gets like her own two sheets. I'm gonna fill it in obviously some more. So each of the major side characters, there's four, they're gonna get their own sheet, and that's that. So these are the minor side characters, so they appear frequently, and I wanted to have more information about them, but they don't get their own piece of paper. Sorry! And then these are the cameos. So these are like the sort of one-off characters who I guess may morph into a different situation, but we'll see. So then this is a full character list, which I will do probably when the third book is done, just so that I have like a full list of characters, which I think will be fun, which I will take out of all of these other characters. Next tab is settings. These are just the settings throughout the book in the two different realms. There's a living realm and an after realm. We're not gonna spoil too much. And then I ran out of tabs. So this is items and lore. So it's like magical items and significant items to the characters, and then lore of the world and everything that I wanted to note. The last one is a future books, which I'm not gonna show you because spoiler alerts. So this is information as I was creating the series Bible, where I wanted to add to future books. So that is what I have for now. And let me turn you around and we can have a chat. Alrighty, so that is the series Bible. As I said, I created a few things that I already want to change, but this is going to be a very much a living document. I also wanted to print out some color photos of the characters as I see them in some of the settings, but I don't have a color printer, so that's gonna take a little bit more work in printing those out. I may send them to an online photo place and have them print them versus me trying to find a color printer because I don't use one that often. So as I was creating this series Bible, I realized that this isn't necessarily for me. It's sort of for all of my iterations of the book. So what I tried to do is any words that were sort of different or had a different pronunciation, I tried to create a pronunciation, a phonetic pronunciation next to it, so that in the hopes of when I do an audiobook or anything like that, or if I work with anyone, a voice narrator, I can just give them pronunciations, and I also could turn that into content for my Instagram, for my pen name, so if people are reading it and are like, I pronounced it this way, and I can do a pronunciation guide, that would be fun. So just keeping track of all the pronunciations of words that may not be well known, I wanted to do that, as well as proper nouns like people's names, settings, things like that. I also think this is a fun little bonus content possibility for me, that I could create something for newsletter subscribers or really big fans. I could take some of this information and repurpose it that way. The most obvious reason for creating one is for my memory, because my memory is not great, and especially if I spent, you know, a year in between books, or if I do like a series 2.0, which I can link to a video if you're interested at all in learning about series 2.0s, which I plan on doing for this series eventually. When I get my other YA paranormal book reverted back to me, I would like to sort of have those series linked. So if it takes time in between, I don't have to go back and, as the series grows, read every single book over and over and over again as I'm trying to create a new one. So that's helpful. I also like the idea of having offline record of my worlds, for the instance of I may be writing in a location where I turn my internet off so that I can focus, and then I can quickly just go through the book if I have any question about something. It's an offline resource that I can access. Also too, if I go to a place where there's not really good internet or anything like that, I would just like having the physical record of it. And I also think it's pretty cool to have on my bookshelf for a very superficial reason. So that's my series Bible for now. That's my first iteration of it. So please let me know in the comments if you've ever created a series Bible, or you want to, or things that you would include in yours. I would love to continue this discussion. And as always, if you enjoyed this video, give it a big thumbs up, because it really helps me get to more readers and writers like you. And also hit that subscribe button and the little notification bell next to it, so you know the next time I upload. And I'll see you soon.